burn out here. It's day one of yet another trip. It's the Labrador City Goose Bay trip, fire dependent. But I'm going to show you my spot. And here's my vehicle that I've been traveling on. As you can see, this is my vehicle. There's my stuff. And this is where I shall be. Good evening, folks. This is your host, none other than me, the burnout guy, on yet another circular adventure. So this here is a really cool evening because it's virgin tent. My tent here, she never been slept in before. This is my new tent. As you can see, I have room. Oh, gotta take this GoPro off this post. I got room for guests. And that there is not the view on Brie or Gertrude. We got field. Camp spot number one. Good morning, CYKO fans. This is Dr. Burnout here. It's the morning show in the tent. I am east of Bay St. Paul on the 138 and near a small town called St. Hilarion. And this is my first morning on my trip. And I'm kind of sleepy. I set my alarm for 7. And I got up. I woke up a few times because I was a little bit cold, you know? So I kept waking up. You know, just cold enough to wake you up. I had to go to the bathroom. It was almost a full moon in a field in front of me here. It was all lit up by the moon. It was cool. So, even though there are a lot of parts of these trips that are routine, and you tend to do the same sort of thing just because it works or because it's easier, not everything is routine, you know. Places that you go to and the people that you see are obviously different. And you are different in some degree on each trip that you do. So, you'll have different needs and different expectations. And different goals, you know, kind of for each trip. So this morning we're going to do something a little bit different. And it's good to be able to break away from your routine a lot. So last night after I hung my food and stuff, it was kind of dark. So I'm going to do the first installment of special words from a special person in my life. Someone who makes me see things and the world in a much better way. In a way that it should be seen. In a way that normally one would see the world if their spirit and their days hadn't gotten trampled on and pushed aside and ignored, you know, over and over and over again. So she has a special message for me this morning. And pretty she looks. This is different. This is not like any trip I've ever been on. Never had anybody with me like this before. Yeah, I'm gonna finish my coffee and have a bite to eat and pack a plane. He thinks so.
Little darling, it's been a long, long, lonely winter. Little darling, it seems like years. It's all right. Little darling, the smiles are returning to the faces. Little darling, it seems like years since they've been there. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's all right.
bug fest, guys. It's serious bug fest. Let's go see where our camp spot is. I wanted a place that was light and open and kind of close to the road in a stupid sense. So I found this place. And here we can do a campfire. Check this out. Look. Right through there. The tracks lead off in this direction. Couldn't do this with the katana. Well, no, not really, no. Here's my spot for tonight. Yep. So let's go take a little break from the bugs.
Sisters, say your prayers, sleep tight, it'll be fine, lover of mine, it'll be just fine, lend your voices. To be free from the lies of love and bravery, and you shall lead a life uncommon. I've heard your anguish, I've heard your heart's cry out. We are tired. Down.
CYKO fans, this is the burnout. Look at this. I am about 120 kilometers from Chacmon. Hi, CYKO fans. The burnout. It's Sunset Dunes Oasis. So right now, I'm going down to the water to challenge myself. A duel with the deer flies. And I'm going to lose. Because they have proven to be formidable opponents. When the black flies let off, the deer flies take over. And when you go underwater, they don't go away. They just wait for you. That's what they do. So, it's going to be a duel.
If it would have come to be, let your words enslave no one. In the heavens you hush themselves to
up your heart and try to get the best of me.
this. I gotta talk loud.
Yeah, maybe I'll change the back. Yeah.
So, folks,
we're in the middle of it.
It is the drive for the unknown which has driven me on. This is the most wilderness trip I can do on this side of Manitoba. I will finally see these small towns, see the lay of the land, and see the northern coastal town of Goose Bay. I mean, like, if that isn't up my alley, then whose alley is it up, really? Anyway, as I've said, I have been toying with the idea of stopping, taking a break, and then heading home. But so far I haven't.
Fans, it's the barn out here in your face. I'm in Labrador doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
gonna go that way.
This morning is very difficult. My old friend, Mr. Road Discouraged, is standing tall over me. He's saying bugs and more bugs, sun, hard ground, sore throat, and just wait till it rains. You're gonna be sorry you're still getting further and further from home. You're gonna be real sorry. And that hotel at Churchill Falls was $130 a night. I mean, good God. The other interesting thing which is happening on this trip, quite unlike all the others, is that my whole route from Quebec to here has to be exactly the same in the return trip. I can't deviate to see a new area here and there. Even if it's somewhat longer or even more complicated, it's just not possible. So that means it's like this mindfuck. For example, when I was having my burgers in Churchill Falls, I was thinking that it's only 260 kilometers to my destination. Wow, pretty cool. Just suck it up a bit, settle down, and write out what the road is about to throw at me. I know I can do it, and it's a question of a day. Logic, right? But then it's another 260 kilometers of the same, the very next day. That's 520 kilometers to get back to the same booth to eat another two cheeseburgers in exactly the same way. Possibly even in the same chair. Doesn't make sense. And 520 kilometers of this Labrador route is not 520 kilometers on the 117. That's over a full day's ride. It's just so much. I really like it out here though, I must say. And there isn't a heck of a lot of traffic on this route. Boy, am I glad I did not bring the snorkeling gear and the wetsuit.